Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chairman Powell, welcome. Thank you for your testimony. We are right now experiencing remarkable economic growth across the country. We have the lowest unemployment in 50 years. We have the lowest African-American unemployment ever recorded. We have the lowest Hispanic unemployment ever recorded. In your judgment, what economic policies have played the most important part in generating that economic growth that we're seeing right now?
Well, I think I'd be reluctant to single out particular policies. I'll just say this, though, that it's been a long, slow recovery, but it's come a long way. We're now in the 11th year. It's the longest since we began keeping, you know, credible records of the U.S. economy in the mid-1800s, the longest one, and we hope a significant way to go. We've just seen continued improvement, and I think I would point to a couple things. These long expansions are common now, and that really is because we conquered the high inflation. We've seen three of the four longest expansions in U.S. history have been among the last four expansions, so it's kind of become the norm to have these long ones. I hope everyone takes credit for the good economy we're seeing now, because it is a really good place. I think it's worth noting, you know, as you mentioned, 50-year low in unemployment, wages moving up at the bottom of the scale more than anywhere else, growth continuing at a solid pace in the 11th year of the expansion. I think it's a really good time, and I want everybody to get credit for that. Mm-hmm. Not us, but.
So I have real concerns that going into 2020, that we may see a slowdown in investments as those allocating capital look at the political scene and look at some of the economic proposals being put forth by Democratic candidates for president. And I have concerns that that may cause people to tap the brakes in terms of deploying capital until at least after the election and finding out whether these policies might possibly be implemented. In your judgment, what would the likely economic impact be of the federal government implementing a massive tax increase?
Senator, I'm pretty reluctant to be pulled into the 2020 election, if you will forgive
and
me.
I certainly don't expect you to comment on the election, but you can't comment on the economy, and if a massive tax increase is good or bad for the economy.
That's indirectly, as you started at your question, it's about proposals of candidates, and I just, you know, honestly don't want to get into that business, if you'll forgive me.
Well, let me ask you, a number of candidates are proposing a wealth tax. Not just on income, but on wealth. Do you have any views on the economic behavior that would likely follow from a wealth tax scaling as high as 8% annually?
It is really not our role to score or evaluate campaign proposals. And, that's what the CBO does. That's what lots of other people do. We really try to stay out of that business.
All right. Well, let's try a different thing. Former Chairman Ben Bernanke in 2014 called the shale revolution, quote, one of the most beneficial economic developments in the country. Do you share that assessment? And conversely, do you have concerns about the impact on the economy if the federal government were to ban fracking and shut down the shale revolution?
I would certainly agree. I think that the energy independence of the United States is something that people have been talking about for 50 years, and I never thought it would happen, and here it is. It's in the nature of a miracle, it seems to me. So it's a great thing, I would say. It's not to say there aren't issues to manage, environmental issues, all kinds of other issues, but I think it's been a great thing for the country.
And would it be harmful to end it?
I
economically.
Well, I wouldn't be looking. I wouldn't be. I think to shut down the shale industry, yeah, that would probably not be a good thing for the economy.
Thank you.